baby. They're used to female only. This is the problem with us, the men. We don't normally carry children. They are not used to us. This is a problem. Baby. I am carrying a baby and a pot, and other officers are carrying firewood and babies. We want to put ourselves in the shoes of women. Recently, 23 young ladies were killed around this area, so we chose this area and asked the questions, why are the criminals targeting women?
Wife beating, battering, early marriage, inheritance of widows, grabbing their property, disinheriting them, all that points to violation of women's rights. And those are still happening in this country in the name of culture. We have laws, we have policies, but when it comes to the violation of the women's rights, we still have a problem.
Uganda police is seen as an institution with the power. So if the men who are in Uganda police take up a position to say no to gender-based violence, this will speak louder to the community than if some other ordinary civilian man say the same thing. You're part of the meeting? Jambo, you're part of the meeting? Please come, let's start. Our time is bad. Over 40,000 defilement in 5 years. Is it right?
Takes a lot to be able now to have people stop committing violence against women. And what we get as police in terms of cases reported to us is just a tip of the iceberg.
We cannot work alone. We need you if we want our homes to be peaceful. Men control their homes. Men are believed to be the breadwinners of their homes. Men are presumed to be having more power than the women. So the killing has a lot to do with the gender inequality.
I noticed there were a lot of people. I saw police vehicles on the other side there. So as I walked this way, I started hearing people saying, the lady from this home here was murdered. The lady from here was murdered. So somewhere there, around these cassava plants, that's where the maroon sweater she was putting on her was hung. And that's where I noticed that actually, that was Rose. It was a nightmare. It was a day which I will always remember in my life. I can never forget it.
These murders were gruesome. All of them raped, either strangled or killed. But in addition to that, they had sticks of cassava or other plants pushed or stuck in their private parts. During that time, every woman young and old, educated and uneducated, felt insecure. And while these murders were taking place, there seemed not to be enough of the investigations that was being done.
This is Rosetti's salon, where she used to work. She had just set it up. The first murder, it has happened. The second one, yes. Maybe people have started thinking what is going on, because they were happening in the same manner. And then the third one, it was a call of awakening. What's going on? It took the murder of my wife, Rose, that the government started awakening. The attitudes that we have tend also to permeate through the police. Ladies were being murdered. Reasons of the murders were being given. It is like they were throwing the blame to the victims, saying they caused this incident to themselves. This government prides itself for bringing security, for bringing about women emancipation. But at the same time, when these ladies were being murdered, the government didn't even talk about it.
At that time, I was the spokesperson of the police until when this problem, we didn't hear it anymore. And I can tell you, it bothered all of us, and we took this seriously. It was never swept under the carpet.
We need to ask the government and explain to the nation why the citizens were murdered blatantly, the way it was done. In our society here, we have a dangerous attitude of men thinking that they can mistreat a woman and they get away with it.
Sonny, you're welcome, sir. We are not starting the match. No, we have formed up. The senior officers from Uganda prisons are the other side.
Within the Uganda police, we are coming up in terms of equality, but it is not yet much. We have also abused the power that we have as officers. We've had the cases of stripping women naked, even raping. But this is not all officers. There are those who are bad behaved. But anyway, there are those who are good, and there are many.
We are ready.
The police, sometimes they are acting out of ignorance. But when you engage them, they are a good ally. They are.
When I saw the UPF, especially the officers carrying the babies, and they are doing it for the cameras, they are doing it for show. But at least the message presented, it was a very excellent message.
When I was growing up, my father used to abuse my mother. So I'm trying to grow up with the mind of, how can I protect her? When can I protect her? This inspired me a lot. And I think this is now what I am doing. It has not always been easy to get other members of the force to join in this campaign, especially the men. But always the beginning of anything is not easy. If I can get one or two men who can listen to me and they change their behaviors towards women and girls, to me that is what matters. With the time, they will realize the benefits of being equal.